This is some real shit I'm about to get into, so just enjoy it, man. It ain't like that no more. Thank God. Thank God, Goddess. Thank the facts, the statistics, all the shit that makes shit happen.
Facebook.
Word. Facebook. Nobody emails me anymore. Post that shit on Facebook. We want you to come out on my fucking page. Okay, take it. I'll take it. All right, cool. This is called Millie Slap Boxes with God. Seeing her so illy ill, damn, on the really real. You don't know the dilly deal. All the pain I feel, Sugar Hill, chilly chill. Even though Millie Mill was suffering, a suffering so similar to little Emmett Tilly Till. And you don't know the pain I feel. Watching hour upon hour, showers upon showers of high level shake seizures would devour. Choking the life from my mama, my beautiful sick flower. Hurt my heart so to see her fall apart slow. You don't never know. You won't ever know to mean the world to someone, then you gotta let her go. See, when someone pulls the unworn rug of unconditional love, the cold floor will creak, a household thug, and imagination helps me make sense out of nonsenselessness. For the 48 long hours, Millie fights against the sickle swing of her barbed wide lifeline. I don't get why she just doesn't let go. Till I remember her biggest fear. See, to her, pearly gates is for suckers. She pissed on a street corner paved with gold. Knowing Millie, she took a sip of milk and honey and spit it in God's face. And they slap box for 48 hours. And every backhand the Lord lays on my mother causes a comatose to convulse ravagely. But she isn't going nowhere. Not till she finds out her biggest fear will not be fulfilled. What is going to happen to my children? I will not find peace in your pasture. As a matter of fact, sell my soul to the dark glow for the glory of my boys. And God says, in his mighty tone,
lady, you tripping? I'm too busy trying to hold down gravity, keep the planets in orbit, settle the seas to keep the mortality rate low down there. You want me to take time out of my busy schedule to look at the two boys for me? Don't you know by now how things make sense even to me? Those two are a couple of a legacy of hardship which begets struggle, and of course that begets soul, and unless they know how to pimp their souls, there will be no glory. It is written that my way is the highway for the fishermen, and that's what you get for naming the Peter and Andrew brothers.
And this is where Millie kicked God in the ding-ding. My Lord, now can I injure my children to their suffering? Can I line up mastery in their lives so that even their flaws are great? Very well. But Andy will suffer from his last nerve. Even though it's not ghetto, I will help him acquire a taste for calming tea. Yes, but he is sentenced to cry lonely tears. But we can make it so that he has a permanent smile. And out of all the talents given when I rolled his dice and landed on him not minding his own business, how would you figure him to make a living? Selling it to the world. And your son Peter, you know he will never, ever let go of the hose. As long as he can raise his daughters into women, holes will never matter. And the Lord finally said,
Jesus, Mary, and Joseph, you got more comebacks than a Chelsea drag queen. Don't peace out. It is on you. There will be no dogs to lick his wounds. Rosaries will do nothing but choke his neck. I will not hold down his fort. I will not lay down the law, lay down the word, my bond, so that those people, that gutter, apple rye, no pistol pie forgotten on you. If Andy does something wrong, the burden is yours.